Monthly budget report, Tim?
Okay, the monthly report, unlike the last couple of months, obviously, our revenue was not nearly as high. We had total revenue during the month, $638,000. About half of that was real estate taxes. But I think that if we're looking at the year-to-date numbers, the real key thing with regard to revenue is that for the property taxes, for the total, we're 45% of budget. And we've collected about 98.5% of the budgeted tax collections that we had for the fall tax collection. As I mentioned in that quarterly review, we're about $165,000 short of our budget. But we're going to continue to get money this month in October and again in November and December. Some of you have recognized that the tax revenue other, which is normally the property tax appeals and is usually a negative number, has been a positive number so far this year. It's because we haven't received, there haven't been any appeals that have gone through, but we have been receiving property taxes that go back, you know, to the prior year. So even though we haven't collected the total amount, you know, that we budgeted for this year, we'll continue to collect money. It's not just, we don't just get the money in August, and we'll continue over the next few months. On the expenditure side, we're only at about 16% of budget for the first 3 months. But that's pretty much what you would expect based on the fact that we don't have a certified payroll in July. Our expenses are very low in July, and then they pick up, you know, the second half of August. There were some questions with regard to the financials. Well, one of the other things I wanted to highlight, I was asked to to report on at least a quarterly basis on the building rentals. For the first 3 months, we were at $21,000 in revenue. That's 31% of what we had budgeted, and it's compared to about $13,000 that we had collected through the first 3 months of last year. So the changes that we made in the facility rental agreement, you know, is definitely generating some additional revenue. Some of the questions that came up with regard to the financials, if you look at the student fees, a lot of the parents, when they come in and pay fees, you know, they're paying with one check, and they're covering registration fee. They may be covering you know, fees for science. They're also covering pay to participate for the fall sports. So what we do is we deposit all that money. We put it under the textbook rental fees, the general registration fee line item, and then once we get past the first few months, then we start to separate it and put the money into things like pay to participate, which is why we show that we're significantly over budget on the registration fees, but we haven't really, it doesn't show anything with regard to pay to participate. But that'll be adjusted over the next month or so as we start to move those fees that have been collected and start to move them into some of these other fee accounts. It isn't real practical to do that all at when you're collecting all the money, just because you have so much money coming in the beginning. It's just easier to plug it all into one account and then transfer the money after that. I did note in the quarterly review that we had received about $24,000 in federal revenue from the IDEA grant, which is a special education grant. That money actually comes from last year. That's something that we would expect. The budget is set up on an accrual basis, so it's what you would expect to earn, in a sense, during the course of the year. The financial statements that you get are set up on a cash basis. And we have to turn in expenditure reports at the end of each quarter. So in July, we're turning in an expenditure report for April through June, and then we're getting that money in. So even though it's the fourth quarter revenue that we would receive, we're receiving it in July. So the fact that we received that in this fiscal year versus last fiscal year.
So you'll always receive last year's IDEA funds.
Correct. The self-insurance fund, I've talked about this the last couple months. When we started out the year, we were putting some of the self-insurance expenses and revenue, or some of the insurance expenses and revenue, into that self-insurance fund, which we shouldn't have been doing. So What we did last month is we cleared out the expenditures, so if you look on the financials, you see that the expenditures in the self-insurance fund are zero. And this month, you see that the negative numbers that are backing the revenue out, so the revenue numbers are now zero. And that revenue and those expenditures are going into the education fund.
Tim, I got a question for you on electricity costs. Why are we running so low? Joel, why are we running so good, favorable the budget on electricity? Is it the lights we put in?
I'm sure that contributes to it. Some other use things we did too. We zoned the air conditioning system all over the summer to try and limit what we were running that way as well.
Okay. Isn't the price of electricity down since last year? 2-10?
Well, the electricity costs so far are down, obviously. And as I said, it looks like that's one of the major areas where we're going to come in significantly on the budget for the year if it continues the way it is.
Are we an electricity co-op?
Yes, we're in the Illinois Energy Consortium for Electricity and Gas. So we're in with a group of other school districts around the state of Illinois. It's a co-op that's run by the Illinois Association of School Business Officials. Although we are going to look at some options that we may have there, or we might be able to save some money.
You had some questions on the financials. Do you want to address those, or did you address those before you get into
I've addressed most of those. The only other question was regarding the insurance. And again, that was in the beginning of the year. We were putting medical, dental, life insurance into the particular departments, the expenses into the departments. And then we talked and we adopted the budget of just creating one line item for medical, one for dental, one for life. So those amounts were credited out, so now those line items show zero, and there's one line item for each of those insurance. Yep.
Tim, Quest question. Maybe answer this before I forgot.
We didn't get into the. Did you get into Quest?
No. Okay. But like.
Sorry, just a real quick one. We get a 7% rebate from Quest.
Correct.
Where does that go?
Where does it go? It goes into revenue. There's a revenue line item. It's a comp. It's in the education fund. It's a food service revenue, and that, you know, it's account 1610 if you want to look at it. And we've been receiving about $40,000 a year over the past 3 years. I think I mentioned in the report.
It at least covers maintenance of the equipment in there.
Yeah. So I guess. Yeah. Well, as I highlighted in the report, the supplies that we've had to spend on the food service program. And the repairs totaled about $14,000 over the past 3 years versus revenue of $123,000.
Super. Why don't you touch on Quest, because that's
the appreciate the assessment.
We might want to, I'm sure there's going to be some questions or want to be discussion on that. I know there were some questions in it.
Yeah, when we went out to bid a few years ago, we used the National School Lunch Program bid specifications that are set up by the state. The bid specs. It's a 36-page document and the state creates this document. And if you're part of the National School Lunch Program, which we're not, you have to use this. But it's obviously a very good bid document going off of food service. So this is what was used. Quest came back as the company that the board at that time chose to use for the food service. What they presented to the board was an alternative. Instead of the district collecting all of the revenue and then having all of the expenditures of the food service, they gave us an alternative program of giving us a percentage of the sales. And it was 5% the first year, 7% the second, 7% the third. And that's what was approved at the board at that time. The contract was a 3-year contract. We've extended it for a year. And I think we met with the finance committee. We talked about the idea of extending it for an additional 3 years, just simply because the program has been running so well. The parents, the students seem, you know, they like the food. You know, we haven't heard any kind of negative comments about the program at all. You know, we heard from Quest last month. They get the students involved in the food items and the menu items. They're very involved with our wellness group. They've just done a really good job. It's kind of like one of those, if it's not broke, you know, don't fix it. So our suggestion was to roll it over for 3 years.
You did give them, they gave an extra percent?
They did give an extra percent. They agreed that in the third year, they would continue at 7%. In the third year, if we rolled it over for 3 years, they'd go up to 8%. I also talked to them about what their normal range was, and I think I noted that in the report, that they do give school districts that don't have a free and reduced population, they do give them higher percentages. Our free and reduced population is up to about 15%. And what that is they're paying for the food, the expense of the food for those children, but there's no revenue coming in. So they are eating the cost of the free and reduced population.
Mr. Walsh, I know you had some questions.
Yeah, I think that's not really true, is it, Tim? If we got 10% instead of 7%, which is a difference of $18,000 roughly in revenue, right. I mean, aren't we paying for at least a big chunk of the free and reduced by taking a smaller commission?
Well, we're taking a smaller commission because the revenue, you know, the revenue is obviously not there because the students that are free and reduced aren't paying for it. But I don't think that, but I mean, I do, they're eating the expense of that. They don't have the revenue coming in, you know, but they've got the expenditure going out.
Well, let's say we didn't have the free and reduced lunch program. Now, maybe some of those students wouldn't eat the lunch, or there'd be another way of doing it, but and we got 10% instead of 7%. Isn't that about $18,000 difference?
Okay, yeah, well, I think
Walsh is saying is that we're sharing in some of that cost, right?
Because we don't have 5%.
We're taking a percentage of it. We're not taking the full dollar-for-dollar revenue, 10% off the revenue. So we're sharing that differential.
Our risk is low. We don't have the employee cost. We don't have the dealing with the benefit cost or any kind of those types of issues. So, I mean, there's some benefit to having that.
Yeah, but our risk is low whether we take a 5, 7, or 10% commission, right? That's not changed by the size of the commission we get. So by choosing this 7% commission instead of 10% commission, we're taking less revenue, which must be offsetting part of that. And again, I'm not suggesting it's a bad thing to do. I just am suggesting that two things. One is we had a presentation, Quest pays for this, and since we're giving up a commission, we're at least paying for part of it, in my mind.
Subsidizing it, yes.
And the second thing is, when you get into the details here, and I told this to Kevin, it makes me think, do we know all the facts, kind of like we have at Aramark, and really, do we know enough to decide right now we're going to extend for 3 years, instead of what we originally planned, was extending for 1 year, and then sending it out for bids again? Because as I pointed out, that there's two parts of it. One is saving the school money to the extent we can, and the other one is, you know, what's it costing our students, because they're paying for it, right? Mm-hmm. So could you expound on that a little?
Well, I looked at the calculations that you did, and I think when we talked with, when he was here last week or 2 weeks ago, and talked about you know, the total amount of sales over the past 3 years, I think he was just looking at some kind of a ballpark number. If we want to look into the exact numbers of what the sales have been over the past 3 years, you know, we can do that, but I don't think we have the information to discuss that.
No, that's not my point. There's Quest, whoever else, you know, Biosima, Skinkis and Walsh, company that does the same thing. Without comparing what other people do, we don't know how this deal is versus other people. We're happy with them. We think they do a good job. But if we extend for 3 years, we went 6 years without considering who else is out there, what other alternatives. Maybe somebody else will give us a 12% commission.
So let me add, if I may, I think when you're referring back to this had previously come up last year, and I recommended to the board that instead of rebidding it out last year, which was my first year, that we extend them for this current school year, and then we look at it in this upcoming year. We had the Quest presentation, which the board requested. I've been checking with Joel to see if we have any issues with the way they're treating our equipment or handling our equipment. We've checked with the staff. We've checked with Pam to follow up with the staff, or she's hearing anything through SA or the students. And then I went through the numbers with the finance council and bounced some ideas off of them. And my thought is as we continue to look through these contracts, we should look at where we're at, where we're at with them, whether we like them or like the service we're getting, as well as if it's cost efficient for the district. And right now, I think we're at a good place with Quest. So I would, you know, that was my, I talked with the finance council about extending that contract out. Now, if a majority of the board thinks 3 years is too long, you know, then I'm open to suggestions. But there are some other contracts that Tim will be reporting out in his next quarterly review that are at the end of 3 years, where I feel we haven't been getting the best deal, or our services aren't meeting where they should be, and I'm going to ask that we put those RFPs out. I don't know, and this is the, obviously we work for the on the direction of the board, I don't know if we need to rebid every contract every time it's up. But then again, I don't know if extending it 3 years is the best answer either, but what I'm saying to you is if we have something that's working well, we're not losing money on it, the satisfaction rate is high.
But the question is, how do we know if we don't bid it out periodically, every 3 or 4, whatever cycle you want, how do we know we're getting the best deal?
I think that's what Tim's asking, and what I'm saying to you is this is the second, you know, we're rolling it for a second, so it'll be a total of 6 years. I would think, you know, maybe we try to put a practice into place like, listen, you never roll a contract more than twice or more than 5 years, and then we automatically rebid it out so that we are checking the numbers.
So we're going to go 2 more years from now, or 3 more years from now? Is your suggestion?
Well, currently we just rolled over the current contract. Mm-hmm. So if we went another 3 years, it would be the next 3 school years.
And it'd be 6 total?
I believe that'd be 6 total.
Seven.
Seven total.
So that's what it's the other year. So this is the fourth year.
Correct.
Is Quest the only one who offers this module, this model?
This model
for the lunch program?
No.
Is that what they said the other day? That most other places participate in the National Lunch Program?
They claim to be unique.
Whatever that is.
I will tell you right now that we were on the board when they brought Quest up. Mm-hmm. And comparing to what the provider we had before Quest, there's a lot of issues on it in regard to food quality and also costing-wise and revenue side. And I think Tim could, you know, just talking to the predecessor could tell you that. And that made us reason to go out and start looking at what we needed to do. Plus, the fact is that we ourselves, with the renovation and the new construction, we're going to be building this new kitchen that it was going to increase, you know, the efficiency of the area, but also make the area nice. But Quest, when they made their proposal, and Dan, I think you know, remember him, is you got to look at, to me, for a bid and that stuff like that, you need to look at 4 things. One is the lack of participation it has with students, being able to communicate with the students to be able to make sure that you're serving stuff. A wise old man for me in food service told me that one way that you can look if you're selling real good is look in your garbage can. Mm-hmm. And right now, the responses, immediately that first year that Quest came in was, they're offering good products, they're working with students. My daughter was part of the screening committee that did that. I think also, additionally, was the rapport with staff and students. Students didn't feel that they were just being taken advantage for, and looking at ways that you can help the parents by putting the card in, to be able to have the swipe card to be able to do that. I also think too is the ability that you have some students out there that are not able to afford lunch or breakfast, and it is shown in studies that you need to be able to, in order for these students to succeed, that you need to be able to provide them with a meal that's going to, you know, help them to keep focus in that classroom. Quest did offer that. I think that if you look at the revenues, and maybe we're going to have Tim check when we had Aramark, I think our revenues are even higher than what we had compared to the last program we had. Do we bid it out? Right now, I think that if you go with a national provider, what I like about Quest is 2 things. One is about how they work with the students, also how they work with the free and reduced. But I also like, too, is that they're a success story. They're not, everybody that they've dealt with high school-wise, you can go and ask them if they're satisfied or not. If they weren't doing the job, they wouldn't be able to get the penetration and the job success they have. A friend of mine delivers to four high schools up in the North Shore. Quest is out there, and I asked him, his question is, how, you know, dealing with these people, how's it dealing with them, what do you see with the kids and that stuff like that? And his comment is that they like it. They do a very good job, and they'll get a complaint on it. Now, if you wanted to only go 2 years, that would make the 6 years, you could do that. But sometimes when you put an RFP out, you got to look at other things besides money. You got to look at, see how it's going to be servicing both the kids, the parents, and the high school itself. So that's my two cents about it.
Do we know if Quest is the only company? I think Mike asked that. In 4 years, there could have been more companies start up like Quest.
Well, we wouldn't know unless we put out an RFP.
Right.
So my recommendation to the board, you know, and we don't have, this is obviously not a voting or an action item today, is that I think we should keep Quest around. If the board's concerned that 3 years may be too long, we could adjust that accordingly.
I also like the fact that when we moved into this contract, we removed the collection of the money by employees and the oversight that we are responsible for. We no longer have to bring in that money, transport it to the bank, and have employees who do those jobs. So we remove some staff in that, in some job duties in that respect. They take the responsibility for the collection, and they report the sales, and they provide the percentage. I think it would be true if we didn't have any free or reduced, the percentage could be higher. But as the guy who made the presentation, I think he's saying that the 7% is fair. And if we go these 3 years, they're going to go an extra percent. Is that a lot of money, 1% additional? I'm not sure that it is a lot of money. But from my perspective, it takes some internal control responsibilities away from the staff here at the building level, that we don't have to be responsible for the people collecting the register, which at some point in time we did have a problem a few years
back.
Yes,
definitely.
And it's their employees that are collecting the money, and it's their employees who are taking the money and putting it in their treasury. And removing that responsibility from within this building, I thought was a plus when we went to this contract. Now, based on what he said the last time, they're unique, where if they're not in the National School Lunch Program, that program provides that if someone comes through the line, they have to give them everything. And so then a lot of that food, they said, was wasted. So under their model, they're giving the kids, you know, what they want, as opposed to forcing certain foods on them.
Right.
And again, you know, when I came on the board, there was a lot of contracts that were not bid in the last many years. And we did things such as the pictures, the yearbook, the cafeteria thing. And so maybe, you know, we should have a policy of how many years we should actually do before we're required to put something in place there. But this particular one, I would be, you know, I would be okay with extending it 3 years. Is it a moneymaker for the district? It's not a great moneymaker for the district, but is that what we want in our food service? I think, you know, Kevin and Tim hit it on the head where they said, you know, we're not getting the complaints. You know, everything seems to be working good. If it's not broken, you know, don't fix it. So perhaps doing it for 3 years would take one less thing from the board's plate and pushing it to the future, kicking the can down the road, so to speak. Because there are some other things that, you know, I'm not sure what Kevin's alluding to, that other contracts we should be taking a look at, because we're not getting the service that that he says that we should, the level of service we should have. And so those would be my thoughts on this.
Does the the student body seems to be pretty pleased with the service. Sounds like they are, given the presentation that they gave. But I read from that that there was no decline in the participation among the students as patrons of this food service, aside from the free and reduced. It's pretty stable, right? There's been no decline for cost or anything?
Yes.
Okay.
It's increased, according to their presentation, pretty significant. My point is, I rely on what Kevin and Pam told us. They told me they're good. I don't have a problem with it. If we had seven other vendors doing other things, and everybody says they're good, until we go out and see what's there to compare, if there are eight, how many high schools? There's 800 high schools in Illinois. West certainly doesn't serve 800 of them. So my only thing is, you know, again, and I take them at their word, but I wouldn't rely on a vendor to say they're the only one to provide some service. And when you bid it out, if you had ideas like Mike that were significant, you put it in the bid. Unless you take the revenues and handle the free and reduce, you know, don't respond. So I think in this instance, I can live with it. I'm just saying, last year we said we're going to extend it a year or so and try to bid it out. Now it's a year later, we said, let's extend it 3 years. And I agree with what Mike and, you know, Matt said, we should have some kind of policy. We should decide how long we should go, because there is a cost to this, and there's a cost to our families, and there's certainly other vendors out there, and we should have some kind of policy of when we should go out and find out what's in the market, and not rely on the vendor to tell us we're the greatest and, you know, just keep going because nobody else does what we do. That's just what my suggestion is.
In the, you know, I think that's got some definite merit, and I respect that opinion. And I think over the last 16 months or so with the board, that the vendor could have stand up there and tell you that they're the number one food service provider in the country. And if I thought something was different or that we could be getting a better deal, I would be recommending that to the board. The thing I want to be careful of is, and that we have to watch even when we, should the board generate a policy like this, is when you hire on somebody and you start them out for a 3-year contract, as they said, they feel like they're just starting to hit their niche. Mm-hmm. And it hasn't been a really bumpy ride during this first 3 or 4 year process. So that's why I was citing that if the satisfaction rate's high and now we feel like we're really maximizing where our kids want to, the food they're getting and the process they're getting, and now they were just advertising a new Gatorade this week and they had free samples of that, and they got Jamba Juice and they got all these different things going on. You know, I'm kind of the philosophy, like, you know, they've earned our trust, that we should extend that opportunity for them to continue to do service for the district, because there hasn't been any concerns that really have risen to the top or have outweighed their performance. So that's all I want the board to think about, because we're going to bring up, there's going to be other contracts that are coming due, and there's going to be some that I'm going to say, hey, listen, the board and my staff have dealt with these, and I can tell you right now, we're not getting some of the same things that we're getting. So I just want the board to think about that, even when if they develop a policy on the length of terms of contracts or things like that.
But Kevin, you know, I'd kind of like to add a comment. It's not that we think it's broken. It's not that we think it's poor. But I think this is the first time that as a board we have the discussion about developing the process, that we just get in the habit, like an exercise of maintenance and looking. Wouldn't it be wonderful if every 5 years we say that this company is the best, and we are kind of like certifying them and, you know, stamping that, you know, sending that proposal out, rather than us getting into a position where it's broken and then, you know, we're, you know, scrambling to try and fix it. And so that this conversation really is about how does the board have a process that's consistent and that we're not playing catch up.
Sure.
And one thing we can do as board members in the interim, and while we think about what's a length of time that's appropriate, is at the school board conference, there's all the vendors there.
Sure.
And there are several of the food providers. We probably ought to be looking at those, you know, carefully and seeing, you know, and asking those questions. Do you do this? Do you do that? And that might raise some awareness for us, you know, if there's anything out there or not. So
it's a great suggestion.
And a year ago when Kevin sat here, there were things that were broken that needed our attention, without a doubt.
Right.
And now a year later, and a year ago, his recommendation was let's push it out a year because, you know, we have other things on the stove here. Now a year later, he's telling us that this appears to be going well, and his recommendation is to push it forward. And you know, one of the things we hopefully talked about last night is we have to start prioritizing some of our things that we want to accomplish. And I think this, since it is working fine right now, it should be a lower priority than other things that Kevin is going to bring forward in the future that should be higher on the priority for taking the time and energy of our staff to bid out.
Okay. Any other questions on Quest?
Well, how do we decide what we're going to do here, Kevin? I mean, we going to vote on it or what?
Well, I would bring a proposal at the action meeting in November.
Well, I suggest one thing.
Some feedback.
I suggest go back to them and say we're only going to do 2 years unless they give us 8% for the whole time. And then we could do 3 years.
Okay. Tim, is there anything else you want to talk about?
8% for all 3 years?
Yeah.
Well, that's Tim's suggestion.
That's a suggestion.
You got to get a majority of the board, then wouldn't need to tell me that's what they want.
No, I don't think we need a majority of the board to say it. You guys started negotiating without even talking to us. You should think about what they're willing to provide.
Well, I guess what I'm clarifying is, like, if they don't give us 8% for 3 years, am I telling them we're walking away from the table? I didn't get that.
Okay.
I did talk to him about increasing the percentage before we even talked about a 3-year contract. And then what he basically told me was that he doesn't have room to increase that percentage to 7%.
What's the annual collection we're getting now? What was the annual we got last year? I think, based on my quick number, I'm thinking we're going to, 2 additional percentage points, 2 years probably only be like $9,000. Yeah. Something in that range quickly. I think the revenue is somewhere probably in the $450,000 to $500,000 a year range, and a percentage add is $4,000, $4,000 to $5,000. So I don't know if he's saying he can't do it. I don't know.
He was saying that he couldn't do it, but he did say that when I presented, if we go 3 years, will you extend it at least in the last year? He said yes. So
because ultimately, where is he going to recoup it?
Years one or two.
From the students charging another.
No, I think
we
put some language in there, didn't we?
Well, we were going to have Lynn draw up a 3-year extension that had language in it that said any price increases have to be approved by the board.
The current agreement that we have with them is like a single-page document. So one of the things we have Tim working on is I have with legal counsel is trying to draft a more thorough document that talks about fixed costs and some things.
It's a single-page document that they signed that says they will comply with everything that's in this 36-page bid specification. So they're complying with a lot of things in this document, which I can share with the board.
Okay.
We'll go back to Quest. We'll put together a proposal for the board to consider action on the 13th.
Thank you.
All right. Anything else, Tim, on your budget report?
No, there was the only thing that I had put in the report is I updated the board with regard to the audit. We received a preliminary copy of the audit. We sent that to the Finance Committee. It was reviewed. There were some questions that came back from them that have been forwarded to the auditor. They also sent us some management discussion and analysis, some of the information for that. I went through that, completed that, sent it back to them. The auditor's out of town this week. He said he'll have everything back to us by November 1st, and he'll be here at the meeting on the 13th. With regard to the audit, there is no timeline for the audit to be filed. I mean, obviously, if you're not doing it within 6 or 7 months. But the timeline of October 15th is for the annual financial report, which is a different report. It's a report that's done for the state board. The deadline for filing that with the regional office is October 15th, with the state by November 15th. They've extended it with the regional office to the November 15th deadline, which they'll make. So that's a different report than the audit itself.
I think there was a question.
Yeah, last year we were told we hired them, they were cheaper, and they'd get it done on time. And they didn't. And the last thing I remember saying, I didn't pull out the minutes, was have them do it on time this year. That was what they said they were going to offer us. Now it appears to me they aren't doing it on time again this year. based on them having to extend it again.
Right, last year they presented at the January COW, this year they're at the November board meeting, so they're 2.5 months earlier.
And we're going to have our state form done by the 15th on time.
We are going to have our state form done on time?
It'll be to the state by the 15th of November.
But the regional, we had to get an extension?
Yes.
Last year, I think we had to get an extension to the state.
It doesn't make sense that the regional would be due 1 month before the state, if it's the same information, so.
I do.
If they allow for an extension, then it's still on time on November 15th.
And just so you're clear on the process, when they submitted the document, first draft, Tim, myself, and the finance council did review it, there were corrections and changes, and those were sent back to try and clean up the process so the presentation isn't as lengthy and is more accurate. That is a contract that is up at the end of the month that, you know, if the board wants to look at, but once again, and you know, it's a cost of how often.
The original bid was they would do the audit for 3 years.
3 years.
So this is the second year of 3 years.
We got another year.
They would do it for another year, and then we would go out if we wanted to look at auditors for the 2014 audit.
We might need to correct the chart, because I thought it might have said 13 on there for that contract.
Yeah, it says the contract expires at the end of 2013, but that would cover the 2013 audit.
The next audit, okay, that's where my confusion is then.
Okay, any other questions for Tim?